Today we are going to discuss about the experiment Zener diode as a voltage regulator. Okay, right now we are putting the Zener diode in between the circuit, and whatever the output, it has to be regulated. Okay, regulated means throughout the constant, whatever the load changes or input changes, the output should be constant. And this is very, this experiment is very useful for your applied purpose. For example, your different instruments, as well as your mobile charger, your laptop charger, your computer supply, and different things, different voltage, DC voltage are required for the constant DC voltage. That purpose, this experiment plays an important role. And after that, we are going to discuss about this whole experiment, and we are going to perform and to calculate the load regulations for unregulated and regulated power supply. For this experiment, you require the sum of the circuit. Okay. Now here, 230 volt supply is connected to that this electric board, primary 230 volt, and this transformer, step down transformer, it will reduce the voltage up to the 10 volt here. Okay, LED glow means you will get the 10 volt AC only. So now you just check 11 volt is near about. Okay, and this is for the AC volt. Okay, once you will get the 230 to 11 volt means step down the voltage. Okay, now we have to make the connection. Here is the bridge rectifier. The output of this terminal of transformer connected to the bridge rectifier, and this has to be connected here. Okay, now this AC supplied to this, and this four diode as a bridge will converted AC into DC, and whatever the output will coming out through this line and ground line from this. Okay, for this here you will get the voltage, and after that you will connect the milliammeter in between. Okay, here is the positive milliammeter always in series. I am connecting here the milliammeter. Okay, now this milliammeter, and here we have to apply the load, and parallel we have to measure the voltage. I am connecting here the voltage, and the voltmeter always in parallel. And again, we are given the load through that circuit. This positive to a positive, this negative to negative, load is connected. Here, this experiment, there are the two parts. One is the without Zener, means without regulation, and second one is the regulated by putting this Zener in a series, in a circuit. Okay, first we will perform the experiment without Zener. Now you just see here this resistance box, this is the infinity. Okay, right now your load is zero, means infinity. That time you will get the maximum voltage. And no load, here is no any type of the load, that's why your current is zero. Okay, now just see here this load resistance infinity, current in milliampere, yeah, you write down here zero, and voltage across this is near about 14.74. okay, now change the resistance 50, apply the load. That time what happens, your current increases. This is the 50 ohm. Now I am applying the 15 ohms. This is the 5 multiplied by 10, 15, and this is the 0, means a 15 ohm. Now your reading is current in milliampere 154 and voltage reduce 6.7679 or 67. Now again increase this as the 100, 10 multiplied by 10, 100. Now ultimately 100 ohm. Now your current is 97 milliampere and voltage 9.66. Again you have to go to zero and then it goes to the 100, and this is the 150. Here you write down 50, here 71 current increases, voltage increases 66. In this fashion you go up to the 500. Okay, and 500 means you have to change the resistors, apply the vary the load, and with respect to this load you have to measure the current and this. So now right now you are changing this as a 500. That time what happens? Right now I am keeping, this is the zero, okay, and now 100 multiplied by 5, right now I am giving the load as the 500 ohm. That time you just see here 25 milliampere current with respect to that load, and voltage is near about 12.70. okay, this is the unregulated. Whenever the load changes, the naturally the voltage and current will vary. Okay, when you put the resistance in circuit, that time what changes you will observe, and that will be, this is the unregulated, and we are going to regulate it. Regulate means whatever the changes, load or input, the output should be constant. That's why we are putting the zener here. Zener diode symbol is this, minus and plus, and that minus has to be connected to over here and this. So right now I am just connecting zener in that circuit with this to this, and positive of this zener goes to the ground. Okay, now means this zener is in circuit. So right now Abhi, we are putting all these things with the infinity. You just see here, all are zero and this is the infinity. First reading regulated with the zener, you just write infinity. Current is 0 milliampere and your voltage is near about 7.41. now I am going to change this, vary the resistance as the 50. 10 multiplied by 5 means 50. You write here 50. Whatever the current, you just see the current. Current is near about 137 milliampere and voltage near about 6.82. Again I am changing this as a 100. 10 multiplied by 10 means 100. 100 ohm. Now with respect to that, your 72 milliampere and your voltage is 7.09. Again I am increasing this. This is the 100 and this is the 50. 1 multiplied by 100 means 100 plus this 5 into 10 means 150. So you just, whatever the change you are observed, 150. Your current will milliampere 48 and voltage is near about 726. Okay, now you change the resistor load with respect to you, current will decreases but voltage will be remains constant, and that's why it is called as the regulated supply. Okay, go to the up to 500, 50, you increase the resistance in 15 ohms. Okay, and take the readings. Okay, once you take the reading, the difference is that you just see this reading here, there are the lot of changes for the output voltage with respect to the changing the load. Here you just see the regulated means the zener is in circuit. That time what happens, the voltage remains constant, very minute change with respect to changing the load. Okay, that's why it is called as the regular. Whatever the load, otherwise input, you can change anything but your output will be constant, and this is the major things and we want to observe here. Okay, after that, right now, so now here formulas are the load regulation you are going to find out on which RL 200 load. Now the observation is the type of the diode used for the power supply, unregulated power supply. These are the diodes, and these diodes is nothing but the 1N4007. Now identify the number of the Zener diode. Zener diode Z6. Z6 means output should be 6 or 7 volt. Okay. Now come to the point. Calculations here. Formula is there for the unregulated means. For this only, unregulated means without Zener. So now formula is that percentage of the load regulation. V at the no load means infinity reading of voltage, reading of the voltage for the infinity. V at the full load means you are taking the 200. Whatever the, when you put taken the 200 ohm resistance with respect to whatever the voltage you will get, and that will be nothing but the V at the full load. And this voltage divided to whole minus it, V at the no load minus V at the full load, and divided by the full load multiplied by 100. And this is particularly for a 200 ohm case. So you will get the percentage of regulation for unregulated. Now for the second regulation, whenever regulated means you are putting the Zener in that circuit. Okay, right now you are the Zener. You just see for this observation table. Regulated means with the Zener. Zener is connected in circuit. That time infinity, whatever the reading you will get, that this will be nothing but the, you know, voltage at the no load. And 200 here, 200, whatever the reading you will get, this will be the full load. And you calculate the load regulation for the regulated power supply, and you are just compare it for the unregulated and regulated, and you plot the graph. V as the y-axis and current in ampere in x-axis. That time you will just, your output voltage for the regulated will be throughout the constant, and when unregulated the load changes, the voltage will with respect to load it will changes, and you just see this graph is going on descending order, and this is the remain constant near about. Okay, and you have to write down all these values over here. This milliampere you have to convert into this ampere. Okay, and this is the way you can perform this experiment. It is very easy and very useful, practical for your FYBAC class. Thanks. Thank you.